We meet in the name of God, creator of the universe, source of true humanity, mother and father of all.
Amen.
We meet in the name of Jesus, word made flesh, saviour of fallen humanity, lover of all.
Amen.
We meet in the name of the Holy Spirit, Lord and giver of life, midwife of new humanity, inspirer of all.
Amen.
Come then, eternal God,
be present here, befriend us here, renew us here.
And in a time of silence, bring to the God who loves us unconditionally those areas of our life that we wish to be renewed. Lord, hear our prayer.
And change our lives until we illustrate the grace of the God who makes all things new. Amen.
So welcome to this service of communion. Particular welcome to any who may be watching us on the video. And for those of you who are watching, it may be that for some of you, you may find it helpful to have bread and wine with you at home to share with us as we share in bread and wine here. Over the years, I've learnt an awful lot about those people from our history, our church history, who are referred to as saints, having been brought up in a tradition that decried that, and a tradition that told me that we are all saints, which I believe implicitly. It did mean I heard nothing about the lives of these amazing people. Ordinary people who are remembered for their extraordinary level of service, humility, and faith. And yesterday was All Saints Day, a special day in the life of the church which partners us here at Whirlow, All Saints Ecclesall. But today is All Souls Day, where we remember everyone that has gone before us in the hope that they have met with the merciful God who loves them unconditionally, after death, as well as before. But I have to say that in all of this, all I could think of as I was preparing for this service, thinking of all souls, was thinking of all the souls in this world that are still alive, who are struggling, who are starving, who are being flooded out. And I suppose it's with the COP26 conference going on. And if I'm absolutely honest, I've not quite got my thoughts together on any of this. So I'm glad that in our service here we have silence where we can gather our thoughts and focus them. for today, the Gospel reading, is the parable that Jesus told when he was actually at some people's home for a meal. And we read it in Luke 14 this morning. And we read that one of the dinner guests said to Jesus, "Blessed is anyone who will eat bread in the kingdom of God." Blessed is anyone who will eat bread in the kingdom of God. And then Jesus told a story, as he always did, to teach sometimes a very, very hard lesson. The words of the liturgy this morning are particularly relevant to this season of All Saints and All Souls, as we remember those who have gone before. And there may be those, as we say this liturgy, maybe people in your own family and friends that you remember in particular. And may I ask you this morning to pray, particularly for my sister, whose youngest stepson was killed in a car accident this weekend. Heaven is here, and earth, and the space is thin between them. Distance may divide, but Christ's promise unites those bounded by time, those blessed by eternity. Let heaven and earth be glad.
Let the whole earth cry in glory.
Heaven is here, and earth, and the church above and below is one. All the saints from far back are here, and those who left us not long ago. Only sight prevents us from seeing them. Let heaven and earth be glad.
Let the whole earth cry glory.
Heaven is here and earth, and the God who made them is present. The Lamb glorious on the throne sits beside us. The Spirit of God makes her resting place among us. God inhales the breath of our prayers. We pause as we bring our prayers to God. Whatever prayers may have been inspired, stimulated by those readings, let's bring them to God. And I invite you in the silence to pray for all those leaders in Glasgow today. let us pray for those places where there is quite literally a shroud covering their cities. For their health services that have to cope with additional illnesses. For their politicians and their industrialists, that they will also hear the voice of God inviting them to the table for all. And let us pray for those climate activists from all countries of all ages, that God will strengthen them in their activism, that the wisdom of the Spirit of God will be upon them as they protest and bring to the attention of all of us the needs of all nations in this world. Let us pray for ourselves. As we quite literally have come this morning to sit around this table, symbolic of the love of God shown through Christ in his death and resurrection. And as we sit here, that we pray for the gift to hear the voice of God, inviting us to do our bit in the world that we live in. And lastly, we pray for all who are grieving today. Those represented by my sister and her family where there has been a tragedy in the last few days. But also for those families across the world who do not expect their children to live. And finally, we pray and thank God for those who have gone before us, who have influenced our lives in such a way that we find ourselves this morning around this table, celebrating the love of God. God inhales the breath of our prayers and spreads a table for us. Let heaven and earth be glad.
Let the whole earth cry.
Lord, you have gathered us together. Make us one in you, one in heart and mind, one in thought and deed, to serve you and to do your will. Lord, we offer ourselves to you as we offer this bread and wine, as the grain is gathered from the fields to make one loaf, and as the grapes are gathered from the hillside to make one wine, may we be one in you. Among friends gathered round a table, Jesus took bread, gave you thanks. He broke it and said, "This is my body given for you." Be with us, Lord, in the breaking.
In the breaking of bread, in the breaking of our lives, in the breaking of our hearts, in the breaking of our hopes. Be with us, Lord, in the breaking, for you alone can make us whole.
At the end of supper, he took the cup and gave thanks. He gave it to them and said, "This cup is the new relationship with God, sealed with my blood. Drink it to remember me." Be with us
in the outpouring, in the outpouring of wine, in the outpouring of our hopes, in the outpouring of our troubles. Be with us, Lord, in the outpouring, for you alone.
You, Lord, are the bread of life. Let this bread be life-giving. Let this bread be a means of growth. Let this bread be for our strengthening, that in receiving this bread, we may be one with you. You, Lord, are the true vine. Let this wine be for our refreshment. Let this wine be for our renewal. Let this wine be for our joy, that in receiving this wine, we may be one with you. Say the prayer after communion together. Lord Jesus Christ,
you have put your life in our hands. Now we put ours in yours. Take us, renew us, remake us. No longer is what we have been as important as what with you we can now become.
To shine upon you and give you his peace. And you know the end of that blessing, it says this is for all generations, the children's children, the generations that have gone before, and the generations that are to come. May we be part of that blessing for them. Amen.